Hello. Hi, hello everyone. Welcome to my channel. Today, let us see a tutorial about how to use Google Classroom. So in this video, we are going to learn what is Google Classroom, how to use Google Classroom, and why is Google Classroom easier than others. So first thing, what is Google Classroom? So Google Classroom is, you know, one of the now because of these diseases, we cannot go and teach in our real schools. So as we now do online classes, we have this Google Classroom, and which is also very useful, as you can create many things in it. You can create assignments, you can create assignments, you can make grades, you can talk to your students and do many more with Google Classroom. So today, let us see how to use this Google Classroom app. So right now, I am in my Google Chrome with my account. Means I have signed into my account and I'm in my Google Chrome page. So now there are two ways to open and see Google Classroom. First thing, before you do that, you have to sign into your account. Until and unless you sign into your account, you cannot use Google Classroom. So sign into your account. After that, you have two ways to see Google Classroom. First way is to use the search bar. You have to type classroom.google.com, and then you will find the Google search one. So you just click that, and then in the top results you will find classroom.google.com. So there is Google Classroom. So just you have to click that button and then it will take you to your classroom. So this is one way to use to open Google Classroom. Second way is this. Signing to your account, and then you'll find the 9 dots, which is also called as the Google Apps. So just click that, and then you might find all your things like Google Play, YouTube, Search, Maps, and blah, blah, blah. So when you go down, you might find Google Classroom. So right now for me, it is in the down part. So it can be for you in the top part also. So you just have to find for the board type thing with, people. So there you'll find Google Classroom. So you just have to click that, and then it will take you to that URL. So you'll again go back to your Google Classroom. So those are the two ways you can use Google Classroom or open the classroom actually. Now let us see how to use Google Classroom. So right now I'm in my Google Classroom page. So if you are new, you might not have all of these teams, but you can create teams. So I'm going to show you everything. So now let's start. First, when you see here, you'll see all the teams. So if you're a new user, then you might find like a circle, and then it might have told you to create or join a class. So that's also fine. Or if you are a user, then this tutorial might be a little helpful for you. So now let us see firstly how to create a class. So can you see that plus button over there? So when you click that, you will get two options. So if you're a teacher, you will get create class or join class. So you just have to create class. But if you are a student, you can only join your teacher's class. But if you're a teacher, you can do both the things. You can join someone else's class, or you can create a very new class. So now I'm going to show you how to create and join a class. First, let's start with create. So when you click my create, you might get this little, you know, like blank. Using classroom at a school with students? If so, your school must sign up for a free G Suite education account before you use classroom. So just blah blah blah. So there will be a tick box and I'll just tick it and continue. So then you will find the create class icon. So there are four things you can do for creating the class. First thing is the class name. So I will make the class name as singing class. I'll make it as singing class, and then I can type up a section. Let's tell 3B, and I can type a subject that is singing. I'll type that as a subject, and room you have to write the room name or number. So that's how you can create a class. So if you are, you know, like a college teacher or something like that, then you can even use room for which day the class is or when does the class come. So that also can be used in the room. So right now I will just type the room as or even if you want, you can use the room to put your name. So now I'll type the room as, the room number is 11. So I'll just type 11 and create. So it tells it's creating. So you just have to wait. So this Google Classroom even can be used for communicate with your teachers and students and many other things. And it's not that you should use Google Classroom only for your online classes. Even at school, if you can use this. So now everything has been loaded. So here I am in my singing class. So before we start with this, I will just go to my home and I have some more things to teach you about here. So here also you will get the Google Apps, your account, everything. So can you see those three lines there? So when you click that, you will find a big menu where first thing in that is the classes. So when you click classes, you will come back to your home page. Next thing is the calendar. So this calendar is really helpful for teachers, as they can figure out when should an event come, or when is the class created, or when a class you have to review a assignment and everything and everything. So that's how calendar is helpful. You can go forward and backward, and you can see what and all assignments you have to review and any other, you know, events or classes. So, and then can you see this all classes? That means it's the default, you know, setting for your calendar. So you can change it whenever you want. Let's tell your admin tells you that in one class there is a lot of assignments you should review. Then you just have to click that all classes button, and then you have to find for that class. Click that class, and then you will find everything needed for that class. So it goes like that. Now to go back home, just click the classes button, you will go back home. Next thing is this. Can you see this line? Below that there is one thing called as teaching. So that's the second section. So that is the second section, means there you will find many things. You can find many things like your classes, all your classes, and one more extra box to review. It's called as to review. So let's tell now you have to review something that your admin told or your principal told. So there are two ways to do it. One is to go to the calendar, search for it, Or the second easiest way is to review. It will be below this teaching section. So if you press that, you will come to this. So here you don't have to go front and back to find your things which is still in process or which it is already done and now you have to give it. So that is a tough way to find your work in process or whatever you review. So this is the next thing, easiest thing you can do. You just have to go to your tool review. So here you can also find it for all classes or a particular class, or you can see all the classes. So I have already created some classes and I have also gave them assignments. So here you can see everything. You can see the name, you can see how many turned in, how many assigned, and you can see where it is in, which class it is in, its due date. And can you see those three dots? So when you click the three dots, you will find mark as reviewed. So if you mark it as reviewed, that means all of your students have gave it. So it will go to your reviewed section. So that's how it happens. So if you have missed something, it might tell you as missing. Next section is, there are actually two sections. One is to review and review. So when you go to your reviewed section or the second section, you will find all of your classes and what of them has, you know, like, means you will find all your classes, or you can find it for a particular one, and there you can find all the ones you have finished to review. So here I had put this Olympiad quiz to join, as it was in to review, but when I put it as marked as reviewed, it came here. So that's how you can use the reviewed section. In the main menu, after that you can find is all the classes. All your classes you're, you know, teaching. So if you've been joined, if you've joined a class, then you might have a down section called as enrolled also. So there also you'll get one reviewed and classes what you've enrolled in. So that's one way in the teaching section and enrolled section. After that, last thing is archived classes and settings. So what is archived classes? So let's tell you deleted one class. Now when you click archived classes, you will find that class. So look here, it tells me no archived classes because I have not archived any classes. So how to archive a class is one thing. In every class there are those three dots. So when you click that three dots, you'll find four things: move, edit, copy, or archive. So if you copy it, two classes will be there as the same thing. One will be copy of singing class and other one will be singing class. Next thing is edit, means you can edit its section, its room, and everything and everything. Move is it will just left or right, wherever you want. So you can get it, if you press move class, then you can just, you know, move it to somewhere. You can move it after some class. So look, I had put it after template class, so my singing class came below. So that's how you should move it. So the last thing is archive class. So now let's tell, I copied the class and I just press copy. Okay, so I just copied the class and now it tells it is copying. It's fine. So let it copy the class. Now let's tell you wanted the copy of that class for an important reason. Now you don't want that class, then you just have to press the three dots and press archive. Then you will get a small command box where it tells you archive copy of singing class. Archive classes can't be updated unless you restore them. This class will move to your archived classes. Just now what I told you about, classes files will be remain in the Google Drive. So I'll just press, I'm fine with that. So I'll just press archive. So it's archived. Now let's tell for an important reason my other teachers want to have it back, because they also want to have that class. So I just click the three lines, scroll down to archived classes, click that, and then you will find copy of singing class which I archived right now. So you have three things you can do there. You can even see your assignments which comes in that small box. You can open the grade book for this copy of singing class, or you can open its drive folder. So when you click the three dots, there are three more things you can do. One is you can again copy that class, or if you have not yet copied it, you can copy it for some reason if you want. Next thing is to restore it. Means now, as I was telling you that if your teachers or your some of your classmates forgot something there and they want to get it back, or you only, there is one assignment which you want to send it to another class, then you can restore it. Or other than, if you don't want to restore it, you can press see your assignments. So there you'll find all the assignments you made in that class. And after that, you can even see what you have not reviewed, everything like how it was in the first class. But just that is private to you, not to anyone else. So that's fine. So that's how you can reuse that assignment or post. And the other thing is delete it. So when I click delete, it will give me another small command box where it tells me you will have no longer access to any posts or comments that have been added to this class. Class files will still remain in Google Drive. You can't undo this action. So if you want to delete that class forever, then you can press this. So I'll just click delete, because I'm fine, because I have the singing class. So it is deleted. So that's an important thing to have an archived class section. After that is the last thing in the main menu. That's the settings. So when you click settings, you'll find things like notifications and profile. You can change your profile pic, or you can go and see your account settings. And next one is notifications. You can receive email notifications. You can turn off it, or you can turn it on. So I've turned it on. I find comments on your posts, everything. I can just set it up. Then it's done. So next thing, now let us see how a class looks actually. So when you click the main menu, there you will go to the teaching or your enrolled section. Then you will find the classes. So you can click that, or either you can go to your the Google Classroom homepage and click on class link. So when you click a classes link, you will come back to your class. So here you have four sections: stream, classwork, people, grades. So in stream, you can see your class's name, you can see for what grade, and you can see a class code. So what is a class code? A class code is when you want to add someone and you don't want to call them, but you want to give them something like a code to join. So that time you have to give this code to them, and then they will find it. Now can you see this down arrow? So when you click that, you will find the subject and the room. So in the stream section, you can see all those things. Next thing you can see is you can post something there. So when you click, say there will be something like share something with your class. So when you click that, you'll find you can do like everything. It's like creating a small assignment. So first it is that for means where you want to send it to all students, means or the whole class, or only for a particular student, like a private chat like thing. Or you want to send it for your many classes or only for your class, only for this class. So I'm fine with this thing. I don't want to change this. So I'm fine. Now I'll share with my class as hi. Okay. So after that, I can add a link or can add from anything. So after that, you can find this small paperclip. So that's called add. You can add a YouTube video, a file from your computer or Google Drive or a link. So now I'm fine. I will just post it. So there are even two ways to post. One is to directly post it, or there's another arrow. So when you click that arrow, you can post it, you can schedule it for a time and a day, or you can just save this draft. So if you post this, that means it will just directly go to their stream, to your student stream. If you schedule it, if you press schedule, you can schedule this announcement to a time. So I'll press schedule, and then it tells me scheduling. So so when you go back, you'll find one saved announcement one. So that one means that only you can see it, and you can delete it if you want. And that's one thing to do. Or even you can reuse a post which you have sent it in your other classes by pressing the reuse post. It's like when you want to recycle something, you are just, you know, reusing it. So now I don't want to reuse any post, so I'll just plus cross. But as I have to show you, I can also show you how to do. So just press that arrow and just then it will come and show you all the classes you have created and the teachers in that class. So you have to click one class and then you have to select the class and then you have to press reuse. Then it will come to your post. I don't want to reuse any assignment or means high bars, so I just want to leave it. After that, you can even select a theme and upload a picture. So when you see in the student's way, so when your students see, they'll be able to see who created the class. So one way to make it more easier is to upload the pic. You can upload your pic or you can just leave it blank. And most of the times, it uploads the pic by the account name. After that is you can select the theme. So if you press select theme, you'll find what you want. So I have kept it as singing class. So I can put any of the themes which I think would match with my singing class. So there are many sections like general, English and history, math and science, arts, sports, others, and many more. So in others, there are many things like these and all. So all random items you can choose. So I will choose this thing and this calculate something. So I'm going to select it as class theme. So it tells changing and it's changed. So that's how that works. Next thing is classwork. Here you can find many things like Google Calendar, your Google Drive folder, means not yours but your class drive folder, and You can even create assignments, reuse posts, materials, questions, quiz assignments, topics. The reuse post is the same thing you did in your stream, but you just don't reuse a post, but you reuse an assignment. Next thing is you can create a small question for your students or your quiz assignment or an assignment. Or you can even create a topic so that it's easy for your students to find. So just if you want your students to complete an assignment, can tell, go to this topic and press this assignment name. So then it will come for them. So that's an easy way to find assignments. And it's an also an easy way to, organize your assignments. Next thing, now let us see how to create an assignment. So when you press quiz assignment, you will find a form. So now I pressed my quiz assignment. So look here, it tells it's creating a form. So you have to give the title. You can give some instructions. And then you can go and then there is one thing called as blank quiz. So that there you have to, do your blank quiz work. Like anything you have, it can be like if you want to give it as a important math quiz. Yeah, so like a test. So when you press the quiz, you have to create it. So now I don't want to create it, but I have to still show you. So there's a for, same thing. You can select it for how many classes it's going, how many students, how many points, how many, what is the due date, and how many topics. You can even create a rubric where if you press that, you can create a new rubric fully. Reuse a rubric or import from sheets. So when you create a rubric, you can add criteria. Like let's tell for neatness. So if it's very bad, then it's 1 point. If it's very good, it's 5 points. So you can create a rubric and you can save it. Or, now I don't want to create a rubric. So when I press the cross, it will tell me in a small command box, discard changes. If you leave without saving, your changes won't be made. I'm fine with that. I will discard it. So if you want, you can even cancel it. Next thing is you can reuse a rubric which you have did it in another class. Or you can import it from your sheets. So I don't want to do any of that. So just leave it empty. Next thing is you can directly assign or you can even schedule save draft or discard draft. So there in the small arrow section, you can find assign, schedule it, save the draft, and you can edit it later or discard it wholly. So now I don't want to assign it, so I'll just discard the draft. So when I press discard draft, you will just discard it. So it's done. Same thing goes with assignments, but you don't have a quiz there. And even you can add or create an assignment. Next thing is the people. So in the people section, you can see how many teachers are there and how many students are there. You can add people. You can email your students or remove or mute a student, or with the student's name and the three dots can email the student. If you have a G Suite account, you can even create, means invite the guardians and email the guardians. So both are there. As I am using my personal account to show you, I've not got that option. Next thing is the grades. So grades is, one of the nicest thing in Google Classroom, because in grades, you might have gave your classwork. So when you create a classwork or questions or anything, in the grade section, you can see how many people assigned it and you can give how many marks for it. So that's one nice thing about grades. So now I'll just create one dummy assignment with the name like that, blah blah blah. And even you can create anything like docs, slides, sheets or drawings or forms, anything. And you can add something from your Google Drive link, file, YouTube. So if you press Google Drive, then it's that you have created something already in your Google Drive. So that time you can use it. So now I just don't want any Google Drive thing. Or if you go to YouTube, then you can do a video search, or you have to type up the URL. So I don't want to add that. And then you can add a link or a file. Next thing, if you create something, let's tell a Google Docs. So I just tell Google Docs and it tells creating. So it's creating and it took me to a new page where it is untitled document. So you have to edit it and do all the work there, and then you have to come back. So here, can you see this small thing called as students can view file? So that's the default thing. You can do many things. You can make this all students edit the file, or you can make a copy for each student. So now you can choose anything. So if you want students to work together, then you can press students can edit file. If you want them only to see, then it can be a students can view file. Or if you want students to write on their own without any other's help, then you can make a copy for each student. And I'm just going to cross it out so I can delete it. So after that, you can assign it. So it tells assigning. So we have to wait until it assigns. So it's assigned, you can see it. So now the next thing you can do after that is to go to the grades. So in the grades section, you will find that name. So there you can see how many people gave what. You can give a grade to it, or you can, and even you can return the submission, or you can view the submission. So if you return it, now as this was, as my kids not yet gave the assignment back, so I can return it. So if I press return, it will give me a small command box, as I had told you that this person has not gave their assignment to me yet. So this, it will give me that return unsubmitted assignment. This assignment isn't done yet. Are you sure you want to return it? So you can press cancel or return. So both are fine. So I'll just press cancel. Next thing is you can view the submission. So if you press view submission, it will take you to a new page where you can see what your students have returned. So when you go that, you will find as they have not returned it, it is called here as no files attached. So then you can see the previous student's next student, or you can even see the name, status and everything. You can return, or you can put the grades, you can put any private comments and many more things. So I just will leave the site. I don't want to do that anything. So, and I will even take out my grades, as I don't want to give anything, as that person has still not returned it to me, so I cannot give it back. So that's what is grades. So if you liked my video, please subscribe, ring the notification bell and like this video, please. Thank you. Bye.